You tell me it gets better in time. You say I'll pull myself together, pull it together, you'll be fine.
The judge in a rape case asked the woman who was a rape victim, quote, I don't want to get this one wrong, why couldn't you just keep your knees together?
Prohibited because we're not allowed to talk about rape in school.
We were taught that just because something happens doesn't mean you are to talk about it.
Just kind of pushed it out of my mind and just tried to get on with my life. And it worked until I would see him again. I would just feel my throat tighten up. I would get tunnel vision. My heart would start racing. And my immediate thought was just, get out. Don't let him see you. Don't let him talk to you. Don't let him touch you again. I had a breakdown and I sort of said, I really need help. This isn't okay. So I was called into a dean's office that late November, sat down on this dean's couch, opened this letter, started reading, and it said he was responsible for offense 3A, and the sanction was expulsion. I just remember seeing the word expulsion and not being able to see anything else on the page. That December, 15 months after I was assaulted, I was free. I didn't have to see him on campus ever again. And so by then it was over. I always have these questions in my mind about, well, why did mine end the way that it did when so many others haven't? It's supposed to be more humiliating for me as a man to say that I've been sexually assaulted in some way, because
it seemed pretty clear that he had assaulted both of them while they were unconscious. I absolutely presume that Harvard would do right by Camila.
I went to the Dean of Students' office and she said, I just want to make sure, like above all else, that you don't talk to anyone about this. It could be bad for everyone if people started rallying around like having him removed from campus. And I was like, well, he's a predator and he's dangerous, and actually that's exactly what I want. Sex was never part of that friendship. And if we were ever going to be introduced, when I was awake would be a good time for that. I'm getting questions like, why didn't you fight him? And he's like, I think like 6'3", over 200 pounds. I was unconscious or just coming to. I like could barely take control of my own body, but why didn't you fight him? There was this extreme reluctance to believe me.
Campus administrators are overly concerned about false reporting. If you look at statistics on false reporting, it's much, much smaller than what people estimate it to be.
Best research from around the world would put the percentage of false reports somewhere between 2% and 8%. Which means 90%, but more likely 95% to 98% of reports are not false.
We got done with the hearing probably at 4:30 or 5 o'clock, and they came back very quickly.
They had found that he had assaulted me.
When we got the call that he was expelled, she was in utter disbelief. That doesn't come very often with these college cases.
The next September, I came back to Cambridge and I got a Facebook message from the Dean of Students. She said that the assailant, he could appeal the ad board's decision, and they voted again on whether to uphold the decision to remove him and decided to let him back in.
The message is clear. It's don't proceed through these disciplinary hearings. no matter what you do, you're not gonna win.
The first few weeks, I made some of my best friends, but two of us were sexually assaulted before classes had even started.
They would protect perpetrators because they have a financial incentive to do so.
The problem of sexual assault on campuses is enormous.
I think it's fair to say that they cover these crimes up.
There's a lot of victim blaming.
He lectured us about how we shouldn't go out in short skirts.
They told me, despite the fact that I had a written admission of guilt, that I presented to them could only prove that he loved me.
They discouraged them from going to the police. If it goes to the police, then it's more likely to end up as a public record.
Universities are protecting a brand.
Campus police cannot contact an athlete.
He won the Heisman Trophy with his DNA rape kit.
Just sit down with the students and ask them, where are the hot spots?
SAE, sexual assault expected.
The second most common type of insurance claim against the fraternity industry is for rape.
Her rapist's name matched the name of two other cases, and he was allowed back on campus.
The message is clear, you're not gonna win.
We started seeing, you know, what was happening at campuses across the country.
Hi.
Hi, has no one connected the dots before?
These students went from sexual assault victims to survivors and now activists.
My name is Carolyn Luby.
My name is Alexa Schwartz.
My name is Ari Mostov.
This is a national problem.
I was getting threatened. It was working in their favor to silence me, and I was terrified.
I thought if I told them, they would take action, but the only action they took was against me.
We've got a lot further to go.